Fifth problem. On April 1st, it is stated that Dinesh started business. So here the business is started. Naturally, when nothing is stated, it is started with cash. So the business is getting cash from the owner whose name is Dinesh. So whenever there is owner coming into picture, we refer with the name capital. So here we write the journal entry as cash account debit to capital account, and the amount being 50,000. Now why we are debiting cash? Because business is getting cash, cash is real account, debit what comes in. Now why are we crediting capital? Capital we are crediting because the owner is giving cash to the business. The owner is giving cash to the business, so he is the giver. So whenever there is owner, he gives the cash, we identify him with the name capital. So therefore, capital being personal account, we are crediting it. Now, next transaction is on 2nd, it is simply said cash sales. So you have, the business has sold goods for cash, cash is coming in, applying the rule of debit what comes in, we are debiting cash. And it is selling goods, goods are going out, and their goods are real account because they are going out, we are crediting them. So the amount being 10,000. Next, on 4th you have the word purchases. So it is purchase of goods for cash. When goods are purchased for cash, we are getting goods which are real account, they are coming in, therefore we will be debiting the word purchases. So the journal entry would be purchases account debit. Purchases account debit 15,000. Now when we are buying goods, naturally we would have paid cash. Cash is real account, it is going out. So applying the rule of real account, credit what goes out, we are crediting the cash. So the journal entry becoming purchases to cash. Now, next transaction is on 6th. So it is stated here sold plant and machinery. Now, here when you are selling, a name of the item is clearly specified. So you cannot say simply it is sale of goods. So, sale of an item when specified, we will always have to understand it is sale of an asset. So when it is sale of an asset, we don't use the word sales. Rather, we have to simply, you are selling machinery means, no doubt you are getting cash. So when you are getting cash, cash is real account, it is coming in. So we will be debiting because debit what comes in. Now, plant and machinery is an asset. When the business is selling away the asset, it is going out. So the real account is going out. So credit what goes out. So plant and machinery we are crediting because it is going out, applying the rule of real account. So the journal entry ultimately is cash account debit to plant and machinery account 5,000. So your narration would be being plant and machinery sold. Now the next transaction is cash paid to Rahim, a very simple transaction. You are paying cash to Rahim, so Rahim is the receiver, apply the rule of personal account to Rahim and he gets debited. So Rahim's account debit, because he is the receiver, he is getting debited. Cash being real account, it is going out, applying the rule of real, we have to credit cash because it is going out. Journal entry becomes Rahim's account debit to cash, and the amount being 3,000. Now let us see the last transaction of the problem, salary paid. Naturally, salary means you are paying to your employees for their services. It becomes an expense for the business. So when it is an expense, we have to debit all expenses according to the rule of nominal account. So salaries account debit. Now paid means cash is going out. Naturally, cash is real account. The rule says credit a real account when it goes out. So Your journal entry is salaries account debit to cash 8,000, and your narration would be being salaries paid.